In this video, we will create a building model from DWG file. Make sure you select electrical as discipline and then select ground floor model. By pressing open, we open the electrical ground floor model. It is possible to model a building in each MEP discipline. Since we have opened the ground floor in the electrical discipline, by default the toolbox is shown with the electrical planning functions. To access the building toolbox functions, change the working mode in the toolbar. Now, open the DWG following this path. Search for the location where you have stored the DWG file and open it. In the Insert File dialog, several options are available. The first step for modeling a building is the definition of an area using the Define Area function. An area is the outline of a building, you define it as a polyline. Activate Use Snap Points and the Use Ortho mode to help you on accuracy. You draw the contour of the building outline as a polyline. When the endpoint is defined by clicking on the starting point, the area will be automatically closed. The area defines the exterior walls as well as the floor and ceiling of the story. The result is a closed polygon with a specific height. The building height comes with a default value, change it to 3 meters. The second step is defining rooms inside the building by using the Define Room function. When defining a room, you specify the inner contours of a room. As is the case with defining an area, we use a polyline. Access the context menu with a right mouse click to use a close contour option. Each room has a description and number that can be entered manually or from the room database. The available room types come with default temperature and air exchange rate. By using the function RecognizeRoom from DWG object, it is possible to automatically recognize room contour, description, number, doors, and windows. Let's start with only activating the recognition of the room contour, description, and number. For the easiest recognition, a room should be rectangular or trapezoidal. When the room has a more complex geometry, the room can be automatically recognized using Room Contour layer in the DWG. If the DWG contains such a layer, open the Layer Wizard function. Move the cursor over a door opening. When the layer name displays, right mouse click and select the option asking to use the layer as a room contour. Next, activate the Define Room function and select the option Recognize Rooms from DWG Objects from the context menu. Now let's configure it to recognize only doors and windows. Move the cursor over the arc of a door. Default door symbols are easily recognized because of its shape. To generate a door, press left mouse when the arc is highlighted. Move the mouse cursor to a window opening between the walls. Press left mouse when the window opening is highlighted. Doors and windows can be manually inserted by using their function from the building toolbox. Doors and windows have default parametric values that can be changed at any time. Use the option Get with the from model when working with a reference. The first left mouse click inserts the window, the second click defines the width of the window. Different types of doors and windows are by default available in the product database. Let's insert a passage door. Insert a door once again, but this time for the garage. Select the door object. In the context menu, select Edit Properties to get access to the door dialog. Here you can change the door to a garage door. Our first story is ready. Let's see how it looks in 3D. First, activate Render Working Mode in the toolbar. In the Render toolbox, you can select a render mode. While in render mode, you can rotate the model by pressing left mouse button and move your mouse. This model can be easily copied to the other stories. Open the next story in the Project Manager. In the Building dialog, select the story to be copied, then click on the Copy button. Use the Zoom Out function to see the complete story on your screen. With the Important Model Manager dialog, it is possible to ghost other stories together. Open the Ghost Story tab and activate the desired floor. Let's customize the second story. Select one of the external walls and press Delete to delete the complete area. Next, select an internal wall from the showroom and press Delete. The room will be deleted. By opening the building working mode, you again have access to the building toolbox. Use the Define Area function and make a diagonal line from the lower left corner to the upper right corner inside the showroom. Activate the Define Room function. Open the context menu and select the option Auto-generate Last Room. After this change, you can save the story with Ctrl+S. We'll now copy this entire story to the story above. The same procedure of the story below will be repeated once more. This time, the first floor will be copied. Let's view the result in 3D. To finish the building modeling, we'll define an automatic roof on the third story. Activate roof function. It automatically recognizes the building area and suggests a roof contour. The contour also can be manually defined or edited. Different parameters can be inserted, such as the wall height and the slope. These directly influence the ridge height. Open the first story to insert a flat roof on the showroom. Activate the roof surface function and outline the contour of the showroom. Change the ridge height to the height of the story, which is 3 meters. Let's view the end result. This basic model will be used for further modeling.